So I thought long and hard about posting this video, and I came to the conclusion that, you know what, I think I might as well put it out there because it might help resonate with someone who has been in a similar position throughout their life and just make them kind of realise that they're not on their own if they're going through this kind of situation. So basically, when I was about 12, 13 years old, I used to be quite a chunky kid. And whether or not this is puppy fat is another story entirely, but I used to be quite a chunky kid. And as you're getting into those teenage years, it does become a big factor in your life if you're carrying a little bit of extra weight, because if you're in PE, or I used to play football quite a lot, I still do play football, but I was playing football quite a lot, and you're getting changed in the change rooms, taking your top off, and it can be a very intimidating thing for teenagers, but not just teenagers. This can be a big thing for an adult. You know, if you ever find yourself in a situation where you need to take your top off, you can feel uncomfortable. And it got to the point where I was getting picked on a bit, I was getting bullied a little bit for carrying that extra weight. And like I say, whether or not this was puppy fat, that's an entirely different matter. It was just, it made me feel like crap, basically, and I didn't feel good about myself. So I decided to do something about it. And whether, again or not, this is because of a lack of information out there or wrong information, I decided to not eat. And instead of eating food, what I did was I used to drink cups of tea. Sounds stupid. I used to have about 10 to 12 cups of tea with sugar in, and that used to be my food throughout the day, and that used to give me just enough energy to keep going. I was burning some of the body fat that I had on me. I was using that as energy as well, but I was doing that. I was a very active kid, so I was doing all sorts of sports. Like I say, football was one. I used to swim. I'd basically do anything. I was a very active kid, very fit kid, just carrying that bit of extra body weight. And because I was getting picked on, I thought, right, I'm going to change this. So I did something about it, and to stop eating food, like I said, and I did this for a good few years, and to the point where I was very thin. And yes, I was fit, so I used to train like a maniac, to be fair, when I was a teenager, but I was not healthy in any way because I was hardly eating any food. I'd get to the point where I'd take a plate of food up to my room and I would just bin it, you know. I wouldn't eat it, I'd bin it. And it took a while for me to come to terms with the fact that, you know what, I'm going to have to start changing this, because I was feeling like crap, I was looking like crap, I was really thin. And the biggest problem of it all was that my parents were getting worried about me, and they used to give me lectures about it, and it kind of went in one ear, went out the other, because teenagers, you know, they know best. And I felt exactly the same. I felt like I knew best, I felt like I knew my body best. But looking back at it now, another 15, 16, 17 years later, I realised that they're 100% correct. And it took me a while of getting told off by my parents. My sister did help out as well. She used to give me lectures on it. And football coaches and that kind of thing, those guys giving me a bit of a lecture in regards to it, give me a kick up the ass. And eventually, after a couple of years, I realised, you know what, food is not the enemy. Food is actually going to help me fuel my athletic performance. Because I was aspiring to be a football player at the time. I was half decent at football, nothing spectacular, and I got to a decent level again. But it was a case of whether or not I'd be able to continue this, because the way I was going, I wouldn't be able to. I could well keel over at any point. I was that thin, I was that drained of energy. So eventually started to eat more food, and eventually I started putting some weight back on. And while this was very difficult for me to come to terms with, because it was a massive thing for me, I just felt I was getting fat. Even though I wasn't getting fat, in my head I felt like I was getting fat. So mentally, I was in a bad place. It was not helping me. Not eating food did not help me mentally, okay? Physically didn't help me, but definitely mentally didn't help me. And I wasn't mentally in a great place, but I was persevering. I think of myself as quite a strong-willed person. And with the support of my coaches, my friends, my sister, and most definitely my parents really, really helped me with this, I started eating more food and started training better and started learning more about training, personal training. And it probably took me to about the age of 20 to actually realize, to actually get to a point where I was fairly happy with my food. But even then, it wasn't something I was comfortable with. Definitely wasn't something I was comfortable with. And that, even going up to, I would say about 25, up to the age of 25, I would call it an eating disorder. I was just not comfortable with myself. I was definitely too wary of my food. I was eating the wrong things. I was eating too little. I was exercising too hard. And this is up to the age of 25. So it's not just kids, it's not just teenagers that have this issue. I was having it up to the age of 25. And then I started really learning about health and fitness. And I'd already started my course of health and fitness before this. And that really taught me in that respect. But it took a lot of patience and a lot of hard work to get to where I am now, where, to be fair, I'm in an extremely comfortable position with my physique. Mentally, I've never been in a better place. I've never been so happy with my business, with my personal life, with my family, friends, football, all that kind of stuff. And it took a bloody long time to get to that point. So what I'm getting at here is that if you've got some form of eating disorder, which you may well have, you may not have, that doesn't really matter. But if you have got some form of eating disorder, just remember, people are around you to help you out. Friends, family, loved ones, they're all there to help you out, okay? And you're 100% not alone in this, because I know from people I've trained in the past and people I train that other people have food issues. It's a massive thing. And I used to dread the next day actually having to think about eating food. And it's sad, isn't it? You know, it's a really sad situation to be in. I was dreading eating food the next day. And it just took a long time. So I'm telling you to be patient with it. Keep persevering with it. Keep eating good food, because the more good food you eat, the better you will feel. And you'll eventually get to a point where you are so confident and so comfortable in your own body, in your own mind, you'll be able to achieve anything you want. But I'm just wanted to kind of get this out there, because hopefully this can kind of help people realize they're not on their own. If they're going through this at a young age, or even in your mid-20s, mid-30s, 40s, even 50s and above, people all have issues with food. It is such a massive part of everyone's life. And the social pressure for us to be in a certain weight and certain position with our bodies, with our physiques, is very stressful. So talk to people. If you need help, talk to people. Make sure you are just, well, make sure you're really, really trying to overcome this issue, because without food, guys, we cannot do what we want to do in life. And I've rambled on a lot here. What's that? 7 minutes, bloody hell. So let's wrap this up. If you feel like you want help, talk to someone. They can really, really help you out. It can help you out mentally, and it will help you out physically in the long run. But guys, just thought I'd get this out there to you. I had an eating disorder. I've eventually gotten over it, but it took a long time. So be patient and you will get there, okay? If you want to speak to me, message me. I'll be more than happy to help. But hopefully this video has not been too boring for you. If you know someone who is going through this, maybe put them in touch with me again, because I've been there, I've done it. Anyway, that's a wrap for today, guys. Have a great day. Stay strong. I'll see you all soon.